Welcome friends, this is Dr. Prashant Patil, Associate Professor, Department of Mathematics, Jain College of Engineering, Belagavi.
Welcome friends, today we will discuss on the formation of PDE by eliminating arbitrary functions now. In the previous two lectures I have discussed how to eliminate arbitrary constants. Before starting with this one, let me have the one or two notes here. If the number of arbitrary functions is less than the number of independent variables, then the partial differential equation is of first order we are going to get. As it is also similar to the arbitrary constants here, in there number of arbitrary constants is equal or less than the number of independent, but here strictly less than independent variables, then you are going to get it as a first order. If the number of arbitrary functions are equal or more than the independent variables, then second order and higher order PDE is generated. This thing we have to keep in mind, and then those partial derivatives we have to find out. Let me solve one example on this one here, how to form the PDE by eliminating arbitrary function. Form the PDE by eliminating functions. My example is z is equal to f of x square minus y square. Here arbitrary function is f. I have to eliminate this f as well as its derivatives, and it should contain only that p, q, r, s, t. P is nothing but again dou z by dou x, q is nothing but dou z by dou y, r is nothing but dou square z by dou x square, s is nothing but dou square z by dou x dou y, and t is nothing but dou square z by dou y square. Now how to eliminate this? Again let me differentiate this one partially with respect to x and y, and then we will try to eliminate that its derivative and all those things. Okay, differentiating partially with respect to x, dou z by dou x is equal to, I am treating this one as a one variable, then it is f of some function of single variable, then its derivative, to apply the chain rule, I am getting it as a f dash of x square minus y square. This is an ordinary derivative, dou f by dou of x square minus y square, but simply we are writing it as f dash of x square minus y square into partial differential of x square minus y square with respect to x. I have to differentiate, that is x square minus y square will become 2x minus this y square will become 0, because I am differentiating partial with respect to x. Therefore p equal to f dash of x square minus y square into 2x. Like that, differentiating partially with respect to y, now this one I have to differentiate partially with respect to y, that is dou z by dou y is equal to f dash of x square minus y square, by treating this one as a one variable, f dash of x square minus y square into partial differential of x square minus y square with respect to y will become 0 minus 2y. Now I will write it as q is equal to f dash of x square minus y square into minus 2y. Now I have to eliminate this f dash. Any operation we can do, multiplication, division, addition, subtraction, any operation you can do, but that its derivative as well as that function should eliminate. What I will do here is p divided by q I will do. P is 2x into f dash of x square minus y square divided by q is also minus 2y into f dash of x square minus y square. Therefore here f dash cancels, then we'll remaining with, as well as 2 also cancels, that implies minus p into y is equal to q into x, or I can write it as qx plus py is equal to 0. This is my required PDE of first order first order, because here only one arbitrary cost function is there and two independent variables x and y. Therefore, in this I am getting only first order PDE. Okay friends, like that, let me form the PDE for this function by eliminating this function f. Here z is equal to f of xy divided by z, and we know that throughout this module we are considering z is a function of x and y. Now to eliminate here, let me call this as equation number 1. Again, differentiating 1 partially with respect to x first, then for left hand side is dou z by dou x equal to, again treating this one as one variable, f of one variable, therefore it is becomes f dash of xy divided by z into partial differentiation of xy divided by z partially with respect to x. Here numerator is also x, denominator is z, but z is a function of x and y. Therefore, I have to apply the quotient rule for this to take the partial derivative with respect to x. Therefore, z into partial differentiation of xy with respect to x will become y minus xy into partial differentiation of z will become dou z by dou x whole divided by z square. Correct? Like that, I have to differentiate partially with respect to y also. Differentiating 1 partially with respect to y, I will get dou z by dou y is equal to f dash of xy divided by z into partial derivative of xy divided by z with respect to y. Again, numerator is containing y and denominator also containing y as a function of z. Therefore, again applying the quotient rule, I am getting z into differentiation of xy with respect to y will become x minus xy into dou z by dou y whole divided by partial derivative into z square. This is a quotient rule to apply. From these two, I have to eliminate. I can call this one as a P and I can call this one as a Q equal to same. Okay. Now, I have to eliminate again f dash from these two. Simple way. If the product is of two terms is there, f dash, then division will become the simple way to eliminate. Therefore, I will divide it again. P divided by Q is equal to f dash of xy divided by z into I will write it as xy minus xyp divided by z square into or divided by this one, f dash of xy divided by z into, sorry, here zx, zy, and here zx minus xy, and this dou z by dou y is under q whole divided by z square. Then f dash of xy divided by z, f dash is cancels, z square also cancels. Then I'm going to get it as P divided by Q is equal to ZY minus XYP divided by ZX minus XYQ. Then cross multiplying, or you can keep even this form also, or cross multiplying, I am going to get PZX minus PXYQ is equal to, that is equal to Q Y Z minus Q X Y P. Then minus P X Y P Q minus X Y P Q, both it cancels. Then Z also cancels here. Therefore, which implies P X minus Q Y equal to 0 is the PDE. Again, you can observe here, first order only we are getting, whereas f is the single function. This is my required PDE. Let me solve here another example. Z is equal to e to the power ax plus by into f of ax minus by. Again, it is a function is containing only single function here. I have to eliminate that. Therefore, again differentiating one partially with respect to x, dou z by dou x is equal to p equal to, I will call it as, then here e to the power ax, this also containing x, here also it is containing x. Therefore, I have to apply the product rule for this now. Therefore, e to the power ax plus by into partial differentiation of f of ax minus by with respect to x will become f dash of ax minus by into chain rule ax minus by is nothing but a plus f of ax minus by into differentiation of e to the power ax plus by is nothing but e to the power ax plus by into partial differentiation a. Okay, then I will differentiate one partially with respect to y now. Then dou z by dou y equal to q equal to differentiating partially with respect to y. Again, both the functions are containing y. Therefore, differentiating product rule again, e to the power ax plus by into f dash of ax minus by into chain rule ax minus by differentiation will become minus b, ax is 0, minus by is minus b, plus f of ax minus by into its differentiation will become e to the power ax plus by into b now. Now from these two equations, I have to eliminate f dash as well as f also. But here addition of two terms is there. If I take division as it is in the previous examples, then it will not go into element. I cannot cancel that f dash. Therefore, let me substitute. This is equal to z. This is nothing but again same as your z. This is also same as your z. And let me shift to the left hand side. Therefore, p equal to, I can write it as p equal to a into e to the power ax plus by into f dash of ax minus by plus, this I can replace it by z. Therefore, az I can write. Therefore, f is eliminated anyhow here. Then, third equation I can write it as q is equal to minus b into e to the power ax plus by into f dash of ax minus by plus b into, this is nothing but again z. But still, if I am dividing p divided by q as it is, then I cannot cancel f dash because addition of two terms is there. That's why what I will do, az and bz I will shift to the left hand side, then I will divide. Therefore I will shift that az and bz on the left hand side. Therefore, p minus az is equal to a into e to the power ax plus by into f dash of ax minus by. Same thing, bz also will shift to the other side and divide. Q minus bz equal to minus b into e to the power ax plus by into f dash of ax minus by. I will divide this left hand side and also right hand side. What happens here, e to the power ax plus b, e to the power ax plus b, f dash cancels. Then just cross multiply and simplify, you get the required PDE. That is minus p into b minus of minus plus ab into z equal to aq, a into q minus ab into z. Therefore, both side cancels, which implies aq plus, sorry, it will not cancel, it will show other side, aq plus BP is equal to 2 times ABZ is our required PD. Here function is eliminated, Z has remained. Arbitrary constants may remain here. Need not to eliminate this arbitrary constant. Only I am eliminating arbitrary function F. Thank you, friends.